of Deputy Ruth Coppinger. Deputy Coppinger to move for leave to introduce.
I seek, yeah, thank you, Ken Corley. Just in moving this bill to hold a referendum to repeal the Eighth Amendment is the simple request in this bill. And I'm moving it on behalf of the Anti-Austerity Alliance and the People Before Profit. Six TDs have signed their name to this. This isn't just an election commitment that we are adhering to, that we gave people when we stood in the election. This is extremely timely. Tonight, the issue of fetal abnormality will be discussed in the Dáil. It would seem that that bill will be ruled unconstitutional, so those women will continue to suffer the horrors of leaving this country for medical treatment. But repeal of the Eighth Amendment is now necessary to cater to legislate for abortion in all cases. That's according to the government. So this is a recognition of the reality of abortion in this country, whereby thousands of women leave the country every year or conduct abortions in their own bedrooms with safe medical abortion pills for a whole variety of reasons. There's a widespread recognition now in society that banning abortion does nothing to stop that practice. That will continue with or without the Eighth Amendment. And everybody really knows that, and it's just brushing it under the carpet. So we have to cater and legislate for this. Now, last year, when a bill was moved similar to this by myself, the government said there was no appetite. This was their constant refrain for any change. It's extremely clear now there's a huge demand for change on this. The most recent poll, Ken Corley, 75% of people indicated they wanted a referendum to repeal the Eighth Amendment. So there's a democratic deficit here as well. It's the one issue in society that people are clear. There is actually a consensus on this. The consensus is to get rid of the Eighth Amendment, then to debate and discuss what legislation is in the Dáil. Well, I see some people shaking their heads, but you're behind the curve, I'm afraid, because young people, women, consistently in polls, there's been a sea change in attitudes on this. The only people who are very behind are the people who saw fit 3 years ago to criminalise women for making these decisions with a 14-year jail sentence. That was very behind the curve. So I'm asking that we would obviously move the bill, but I'm also appealing to young people, women, to pro-choice organisations to use the next 100 days to contact their TDs, to discuss with their TDs, to meet with TDs in their clinics, to seek appointments with TDs, to have a debate now in the next 100 days about why we have to repeal the Eighth Amendment. That's why we are giving notice of this time, so that organisations can actually do what should be done, which is ask their TDs to represent what is now a clear majority of people who favour repeal of the Eighth Amendment.
Being opposed? That's not being opposed. The